All right, so tell me this, man. Yo, you've been on since 2016, 2013, according to IG. How long you been doing the comedy thing?
Man, the... Bro, I would really say, like, actually, like, trying.
Like, going hard.
Just, like, attempting and, like, starting saying, like, all right, I'm going to start putting out videos. I would say 2018. For sure, 2018. Maybe the end of 2017. Like, because I, you know, for me, bro, you know, most people's Facebooks, they have, like, you know, you got your close friends. Y'all make local jokes. So I would always do little funny videos about my people. And you follow me on Facebook, so you know what I'd be doing. So that's all I would do. And I think I made one video where I was working out, and I was doing like the Dougie, you know, that originated in Dallas. Right. So I did like a workout. So I had the weights and I was Dougie and I did all different kind of stuff. And it kind of like went viral. Like for me, 35,000 views, like that's a lot. For
Hell yeah. Especially at that time.
Bro.
Right. Even
that's still like a lot, you know, on Facebook. But it went viral a little bit and I was like, okay, maybe I got something. So then I came back with like a H-Town, like Southside. So I did like the Southside version of the workout and it kind of did well. So then I was like, all right, let me just keep going. And then I ended up doing that Crip Fit.
Oh man, we got to talk about the Crip Fit.
I started doing that Crip Fit, man. And that mug took off.
That's all it was, is you was already doing the workout thing, and then you just said, let me find different ways to do this.
Well, see, most of the time, like, so this is me, bro. When I work out, if people that know me, they know when I work out, I'm always dancing, I'm jigging.
Right, right.
You know, I'm working out hard, but, like, I'm playing, like, I just feel the music. To me, it's like cardio. You're constantly moving. Like, I'll be in there sweating. I'm in my garage.
Good, right.
That's why I call it the sweat box, because I do not let the door up. So if you work out with me, you finna sweat.
Okay.
I can't even go to the gym anymore because it feels too cold or whatever. But
oh, you there, you going that hard.
Bro, if it's 97 outside in the sweat box, it's probably 101. But
and that's another thing too, because you in Texas.
Bro, that Texas heat is different.
Yeah, I've had the Vegas heat. Is it like Vegas heat?
Vegas
like dry. See, dry ass.
Where it's just like where it's really hot, it's just hot. In Texas, it's hot and humid.
Cause you're about by the water, right?
You sweat and then it's sticking on you. Like there's no comfort, like you can't get comfortable. Then you got mosquitoes. Like then you got traffic. Like it's a whole thing down here. But like that whole trip, bro. I was working out, like listening to like YG Nipsey. I start, you know, crip walking around. I had my son running around playing on his little jungle gym that I have in there for him. And then I was like, I said, man, this could be a video. Went and grabbed my phone, set it up, and I just started doing random stuff that I could crip walk to. Edited on my little S6 phone. Right here, the start of the video. My son ran through on accident on one part.
And it was perfect.
To me, perfect. It was like nothing. It was like cool, funny. But everyone else loved it. And I was like, and that's how it be, bro. It be the one video that you don't care nothing about, they love.
But the one you put the time in, I'm like, oh, I'm finna kill him with this. It be your worst shit.
I feel 5 a.m. editing. You drop that mug. You got a special thumbnail. You got perfect 17 views.
But the one you just say, hey, man, hey, take a picture of me real quick doing this.
Oh, Reese, you crazy, man. I'm like, nah, y'all crazy.
You know what I've noticed too, like with videos, when I'm editing things that I, because you edit your own shit too, right? Yeah. So like when I'm editing, I'll be like, okay, that's a funny part. That's a funny part. That's a funny part. And then you post it. And then things that you didn't even think would be the funny part, other people think are funny.
I think in the back of that Crip Fit video, on my wall, it's supposed to say the sweat box. But when my sister-in-law was putting it up there for me, like as a surprise, the DASW fell off. So now it says eat box.
Oh, so that's just perfect.
But everyone was like, man, why did he not eat box back? He freaky. Like, so.
Right.
Layers, bro.
But that video popped. How many views did you get on that video total, or like across the board?
So just
gotta be multiple millions.
Bro, it got millions. a whole gang of people, like celebrities, everybody reposted it.
Snoop Dogg posted it too, didn't he?
Well,
it was on Snoop's page.
Right, Trey the Truth, he showed it to him, but he didn't post that one. If he did, I didn't see it. But I know that he's seen the video.
I swear, I thought you'd see. I could be wrong. I thought
Snoop posted that drunk freestyling video.
That's what it was. That's what the drunk freestyle, which is still love. How did that feel?
Bro, I was like, why would he post that video? Like, how did he even find that one? I was like, that video was over a year old. It did okay on my page at that time. It's like, how did you see this? Like, how did Snoop, how did this come across your screen? How did like why hasn't CryptFit been the one thing that he reposted?
Yeah, and that was a good point. You're right.
The story behind that, fam, is I randomly made the video when I dropped it because I have a Twitter, but I didn't, you probably neglect certain social medias a little
Twitter
bit.
Is the one I neglect.
Twitter for sure is what I neglect. So I didn't put it on Twitter. Someone took it from my, from either Instagram or Facebook. They took it from there, cut off the ending in the beginning where I had my tag, and it went viral.
Because you was like, because y'all tagged me in it, because which is, it's your shit.
Bro, I sent probably 1,000 people, hey, man, please, thanks for sharing the video. Can you please tag me? Because, like, Chris Brown shared it. Like, my wife woke me up at, like,
2. I know. She was like, nigga.
Let me tell you what she did. She didn't say, hey, babe, look, Chris Brown posted it. She was like, you think you the shit, don't you?
Why ain't be on that?
I'm in my sleep, so I'm like, what? I ain't texting nobody. I haven't, like, done nobody. I'm a good, faithful black man. Like, what's going on?
Black man, don't you?
Like, she's like, look at your phone. And I looked. I'm like, Chris Brown? I had to make sure I had the little check by his name. I'm like, oh. So I'm getting ready to, like, screenshot all that. When I go back to it, it's gone. After 20 minutes.
Evidently, so he took it down?
I think he took it down because, he's a blood. So...
Oh,
I think maybe someone might have said something to him.
You got the screenshot though for your own thing?
Yep.
Hell yeah.
Everybody, like, when you got that one person that share your stuff, you'd be like,
yeah. My best one was Kodak Black liked one of my gems, and I was like, oh, if somebody showed me, I didn't even notice. When you get all the likes, you can't see all of them. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then somebody's like, bro, you know your shit. I'm like. And I screenshot the hell out of Kodak Black. So that's probably the biggest one that I know maybe other people have seen it, but that was the only one that I could prove have seen it. You know what I'm saying?
Most definitely someone else has seen your stuff. Cause some of them dudes, I don't think they can like certain stuff. Like they can, but I think every time they like something, someone always screenshot it.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Hey, look, you like this. Let's take away his endorsements.
what was the moment that you said, yep, I got to do this?
Probably when that, which one did I have? I think when that CryptFit really hit, that's when I was like, I think I can kind of turn this into something. Cause that's when like a lot of people kind of started reaching out to me. People like around Houston kind of started noticing me. And then like, I do a lot of Houston content.
Yeah, so with the scratch and screwed and the lean. I love those.
Like, bro, I grew up on that. You know what I'm saying? So like that's, to me, I feel like if you do what's natural to you, your audience can see that, and then they're gonna really rock with you because you're not being fake. Like, I'm not doing no, like, I'm no thug. So when I'm acting like one, you can tell I'm acting like one, like being funny.
Silly, yeah.
I'm not trying too hard to do that because I know that's not me or whatever. So like the whole H-Town thing, that's in my blood. Like that's
right,
easy work.